Assalamualaikum and a very good day again. Okay, in this session, we're going to be drawing the diagram of the right popliteal fossa seen from the posterior view. Okay, we'll start right now. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. In the name of Allah, most kind and most merciful. Okay, we'll start by drawing a diamond-shaped figure. Follow me, eh? Okay, the diamond-shaped figure represents the border of the popliteal fossa. Next, we're going to be drawing the contents of the popliteal fossa, which is we'll start by drawing a vertical line extending from the top vertex until the bottom vertex, and then we're going to be drawing another line which runs along the upper lateral body. Oh, okay, sorry, forgot to mention. This one is the medial border. This one is the lateral border. Okay. So, we have, this one is up, this one is down. The line I'm talking about runs along the upper lateral border. So, runs along this one. Okay. And then, goes out of the border. Okay. Next, we're going to be drawing another line which is medial to the first line, and the last line medial to it. Okay, as we already know, yellow represents nerve, blue represents vein, and red represents artery. Okay, I'll tell the names of the vessels later. Okay, next is, we'll start by drawing, the lymph nodes. Okay, this drawing is based on the book Natter Atlas of Human Anatomy, and in that book, the lymph nodes are drawn like this. First one, second one, third one, and fourth one. Okay, I'll add one more a vein which drains into the this vein right here, which is the small saphenous vein. Okay, I'll talk about it later. And that's probably it. This is the complete diagram already. Okay, we'll now proceed with the labeling. Okay, the mnemonic I use is surf and volley next ball. Okay, for the mnemonic, right, I'll just take the first letter of the words, which is S, A, V, N, and B. Okay, for this mnemonic, it actually comprises for both the borders and contents of the popliteal fossa. Okay, the first one is S. Where? This one. I'll use initials S and S, which represents semitendinosus and semimembranosus. Okay, A. Yeah. I'll label first. This one, and then the one in the middle, and this one. Okay, so A represents for popliteal artery, V representing popliteal vein. Okay, for this one, the N represents two nerves, which is, okay, the first one is tibial nerve, and then the one lateral to it is common peroneal nerve, see, P, N. Okay, the last one, B, represents the upper lateral border, which is made out of biceps femoris. Okay, now we're missing four more labels, which is, okay, I'll just drag this one, but it actually represents all four of the lymph nodes. Next is this one. Okay. This one is the popliteal lymph nodes. This one is the small saphenous vein. Okay. Now we'll label the lower medial border, which is I'll label it here, medial gastrocnemius, and this one, the lower lateral border, which is formed by lateral gastrocnemius. And that's it. That's a complete diagram of the popliteal fossa. And now we'll add a little bit more info. Okay. So the first one is for the vessels, right? It's actually arranged according to the different depths. First one, the most superficial one, the nerves. Okay. Deeper to it, we have the vein. And then deeper to it, we have the artery. Okay, so according to this information, right, the artery is actually located deepest inside the popliteal fossa, which is why most of the time, popliteal pus is actually one of the main pus points in the body, but it's actually quite hard to palpate it because of this, because of the arrangement. Okay, next we'll add more information. The roof of the popliteal fossa, which is made out of the first layer, the skin. Deeper to it, we have the superficial fascia. And then deeper to it, we have the deep fascia. Okay, skin, right? More information we'll add. The floor, or in some book, they use the term anterior wall of the popliteal fossa. Okay. This one, not really arranged according to the layers. First one is popliteal surface of femur. Next one is oblique popliteal ligament. And the last one is the popliteus muscle. And I think that's it. Quite easy. Anything else I'm missing? Okay. The upper medial, semitendinosus, semimembranosus, upper lateral, biceps femoris, lower medial is medial gastrocnemius, lower lateral is lateral gastrocnemius. For the structures inside, the contents is popliteal artery, popliteal vein, tibial nerve, common peroneal nerve, popliteal lymph nodes, and the last one, small saphenous vein. Yep, that's it. I didn't miss anything. That's it for this video. Okay, thank you and JazakAllah Khair for watching it.